in a secluded cove, 65 miles up the Potomac River.
This place is mystical.
Rests an obscure and arcane tale of history.
When I was a young boy, I came down here with my father. We bumped into a waterman, and he said, "You boys going to look at the ghost fleet?"
The legend of what lies here, submerged in this hauntingly beautiful sight, begins in the throes of the war to end all wars, World War I. In 1917, desperate to move war supplies across the Atlantic, President Woodrow Wilson issues a call to arms against Imperial Germany. Hoping the sheer force of numbers will overpower the Kaiser's treacherous fleet of U-boat packs, Wilson orders a massive boat-building program. Boatyards around the country busily assemble and launch hundreds of merchant vessels. But the audacious plans turn to folly, and the fleet winds up here, scuttled in its final resting place, a ghost fleet in Mallows Bay. Don Chaumette discovered Mallows Bay as a boy, paddling these waters with his father.
If you look at the iron pins in here, all arrayed in formal lines, they remind me of soldiers in the trenches in World War I.
Now a maritime historian, Chaumette and a team of marine archaeologists excavated and mapped the whole of this nautical burial ground.
You see the outline of the ship right there. That's the North Bend. That's the first ship that was built in World War I for the U.S. Shipping Board fleet. At one time, you could go from the north end of the bay all the way to the south end without touching the water by just skipping from vessel to vessel. Wow, I have never seen this so exposed. You can see the engine mount, and that is the shaft tunnel going out towards the Potomac. This is an unknown section of Maryland. It is a representation of shipbuilding that made America, for the first time in its history, the greatest shipbuilding power on the planet, right here in Mallows Bay.
This is the largest marine burial ground in the Western Hemisphere. The remains of well over 150 World War I era steamships lie in these shallows, alongside many other derelict vessels dating from the late 18th century through the 1980s. Like the old Accomack passenger ferry, a towering hulk left for scrap. But they are mostly the World War I wrecks that arrived in Mallows Bay during the mid-1920s through some peculiar twists of fate. Before any of the vessels could make it to the war, the Germans surrendered. With hulls of wood, not steel, they were obsolete as soon as they were launched. And after the war, nobody wanted them. So what cost the U.S. government $500 million to construct was let go to the only bidder, a Virginia salvage company that hauled the boats to Mallows Bay, stripped them of valuable metals, and abandoned them. One morning alone in 1925, 31 ships were lashed together and torched in a massive inferno that symbolized the end of a chapter in American military history.
This looks like the shoreline, but actually it is a line of about five ships lined up out astern. The flower pot wrecks, and you can see there's trees growing on them, some maybe 30 feet tall, 25 feet tall.
What Chaumette calls the flower pot wrecks are the boats serving as foundations for newly grown ecosystems. So many ships crammed in such shallow water have produced this happy environmental side effect.
On board these vessels, deer, river otter, beaver, myriad birds make their homes there.
The water temperature within the wrecks is slightly warmer, so fish not only spawn here, they stay here, making it a terrific spot for bass fishing.
I love it all the time. It's a step into the past, but it's a step into Mother Nature that few people ever get to see.